Students, baat start karenge about a particular wide area network technology, and the name of the technology is SONET, or Synchronous Optical Network. Students, this SONET or Synchronous Optical Network, as I told you, it's a WAN transport technology, which is used to carry the data from the underlying wide area networks over long distances. Students, fiber optic signals and fiber optic cables is what we use in the case of SONET. And the reason for that was that the fiber was detected as a medium that had higher bandwidth and which is capable of carrying today's high data rate applications. For example, video conferencing and other high data rate applications as well. Students, once this transmission medium was identified as a medium that is capable of carrying these high data rates, this SONET technology or SONET standard that was developed. Students, SONET is basically an ANSI standard for United States. The equivalent standard of SONET that is used in Europe and is developed by ITUT is called as Synchronous Digital Hierarchy or SDH. Both of these standards are independent standards, but they are very compatible, as you will see in the next slides to come. Ab students, apni discussion ko hum log start karenge about SONET by discussing the architecture of a SONET network. And students, if you're going to talk about the architecture, we're going to talk about three different things. We're going to talk about the signals that are carried in a SONET network. We will talk about the different devices that make up a SONET network, and we'll talk about the different connections that exist in a SONET network. Students, sabse pehle signals ki baat karenge aur teen signals ke bare mein main aapko bataunga using a particular diagram of a simple SONET network. And the signals, the first one is synchronous transport signal or STS signals, which is a signal that was specified in the SONET, ANSI SONET standard. Then we'll talk about the optical carriers. Once again, it's also a ANSI standard. And then we'll talk about the STM or synchronous transport modules, STM signals, which are equivalent to STS signals. And we'll talk about that, so don't get confused right now. But STM signals are specified by the ITUT standard. So let's talk about SONET devices. We'll talk about the STS multiplexers and demultiplexers. We'll talk about regenerators, which are equivalent to our analog repeaters that we spoke about, and we'll further discuss them in the discussions to come. And then we'll talk about the add-drop multiplexers and the end-user terminals, which actually send the electrical signals that we convert into optical carriers. So since lastly, we'll talk about some connections. What are the different connections that exist in our SONET network? We'll talk about the concept of sections. We'll talk about the concept of lines. And we'll talk about the connection, the concept of paths as well. Students, moving on to this slide, this actually talks about the different SONET signals. We're talking about the SONET architecture. And this first slide actually talks about the different types of SONET signals that are available. Students, synchronous transport signals or STS signals are that is the hierarchy of the electrical signal levels that SONET standard supports. Students, each STS level that you're looking at on the in the first column, it supports a particular data rate that is specified in column number 3 in the table that you're looking at, and the data rate is specified in megabits per second. Students, the corresponding optical signals are also present in column number 2 of this slide. They are called optical carriers, or OC is what we use for them. And then ITUT SDH specifies certain STM signals as well, which are given in your last column. So students, in the first case, your STS and your OC, this is your ANSI SONET standard. And then you've got the equivalent SDH standard, which specifies synchronous transport modules as well. And you can see we have done a comparison between the ANSI electrical signal standards and the corresponding optical carriers and the STM standard by using the data rate that they support. So it's very interesting. As you can see, let's take an example of STS-1 or OC-1 in the Sonnet standard. It supports a data rate of 51.84 megabits per second. Students, yaad kijiyega, this is very close to the data rate that we specified when we spoke about the DS3 services. So students, in this particular case of 51.84, it is greater than that of DS3, which was 44.73. And if you add the headers and stuff, we come up with 51.84. So in fact, this STS-1 was originally designed to accommodate the data rates that are equivalent to the particular DS3 standard that we studied. Students, another important or interesting fact is, if you can see, we can multiplex multiple STS signals into the other one. For example, as you can see, if you multiplex three STS-1 signals, you get an STS-3 signal. 51.84 multiplied by 3 is 155 megabits per second. Similarly, if you multiplex three STS-3 signals, you get an STS-9 signal, and so on. So students, the concept is that we can multiplex the lower data rate STS signals into these high data rate STS signals if we want to carry them over a Sonnet line over long distances. The basic unit is STS-1 for Sonnet, but we can multiplex that to a higher data rate if you've got a higher bandwidth available on the optical fiber cable and we want to carry this data over long distances. Students, in IT-UT languages, the STM-1 standard, which is the minimum unit of the SDH system, that corresponds to STS-3 and has got a data rate of 155.52 megabits per second. And then from that point onwards, you have got STM-3 equivalent to STS-9, STM-4 equivalent to STS-12, and so on. And this is basically what we use in Europe, and your NSAI or Sonnet standard is what we use in USA.